What's an exciting football season?
How did that moment feel, scoring?
I feel very proud and happy. I think I feel really good and really happy because as a player, it's one of the biggest experience you have to have in your football career, and one of the biggest achievements. I think I feel really, really great.
Okay, how did your teammates accept you in camp? How was the mood in camp?
I think the mood here is it's very nice. Different experience, different people. They are all nice, calm, welcoming. I think I feel I feel welcome. Because, there's nothing to be scared of. I just feel relaxed and welcome.
Going into the Nations Cup, how far do you think we can go at the Nations Cup?
I think Nigeria is a football nation, and I think we, with the players we have, we can really go very far if we work hard and focus and, listen to what the coach asks us to do. I think we can really go far. Yeah.
Okay, the bunch of squad we have are pretty young players, and just a couple, one or two thereabout, have made it into the Nations Cup. Like right now, players have played at the Nations Cup. Most of our players have not been at the Nations Cup. Going into the Nations Cup, do you think this is going to affect us?
I don't think so, because like I said, it's all about working hard. It's all about having the courage to do what the coach asks you to do, and having the courage to just go and play and enjoy what's how to do best. And I think the hard work will pay off in the AFCON.
So if I'm to put you on the hot seat, do you think we can win the AFCON 2019?
Of course, you have to believe as a player that you're capable of doing anything. Of course, I think we are capable of winning it with the players we have and with the country as in Nigeria we are, and every other nation are scared of us when they hear the name Nigeria. So I think we are capable of winning it.
Okay, good. Let's talk about your time in Denmark. You've had a very good season, back to back, because you've been doing double figures, goals. How has your time been in Denmark?
It's been good. It's been great. It's like you said, I've been playing, and of course I'm getting the goal scoring. It's been really good in Denmark since I've been there. Just looking forward to continue, and looking forward for a new thing. Just to try other things, try other challenges, and other clubs. So far I've been I've been doing really good in Denmark.
Okay. You played at the Europa League, and I can remember you scored against Arsenal, if I'm not mistaken. Mind you, sorry, yes. How did that moment feel?
Yeah, it feel good, because it's the biggest club I have played in my career, and Man United, Premiership, everybody knows them, and scoring a goal against them, I think it's a big thing in my football career.
You guys eventually won that game. How did it feel?
Yeah, we did. It feels so good winning against Man United, and in the dressing room it was crazy. We were all dancing and happy. Yeah, I think it's a big thing for me and for the club that we won against Man United.
Okay, in your football career, you've played against some of the best players. But for you, who do you think is the toughest opponent you've met?
The toughest player you've played against, a lot of players. Sometimes you remember, sometimes you don't remember. I think some players I've played against, most of them are tough, but I could remember I played against this guy Koulibaly from Napoli. We played against them in, I think, in Napoli. I think he's, I would say he's one of the toughest defenders I've played against.
And we might perhaps face Senegal at the Nations Cup. You coming away?
Yeah, sure. It doesn't matter for me because, you know, this, we are talking about 3 years back or something. So, yeah, now if I played against him, of course, anything can happen in football.
Okay, let's talk about offers now, right now. Are there any offers on table, and where would you like to play next?
Yeah, sure. For the past 2 years or 2.5 years, there have been offers, you know, but probably I think the teams can't really reach the amount my team is putting on me, and that's why I'm still in Midtjylland. So, of course, I have the height. I can fit in any league, Germany, you know, France, Premier League, anywhere, you know. Yeah.
Some of these offers, can you name a few clubs that have shown interest?
No, I'm not gonna say that here. Yeah,
well, are there like any Premier League clubs on the list?
No.
Or La Liga?
No, I heard of the Premier League club, but you know, it's difficult when you haven't gotten a lot of national team, you know.
In camp right now, who are your closest friends in camp? Because it seems you're quite new with the camp, but who are your closest friends?
Of course, I'm a football player, and of course I know each and every one of them, but not like close. But I think right now I know I'm close to some of them. I talk with some of them. People I talk most with, Osimhen, Henry Onyekuru, John Ogu, and that's the ones I, you know, I talk to most. But others too, I talk to them too, you know. They're all free to talk to, you know, they're all welcoming, so yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, for next season, I think my plan for next season, my hope now and dream is to, you know, leave Midtjylland and, you know, go try something new, some other challenges, you know, and see how it is there, you know. So I think that's the plan I'm focusing now for next season, to do all I could this season and to move on to face other challenges.
Okay, let's talk briefly about growing up. How was growing up for you? The football. When did you find love in football, and at what age did you realize you were going to become a footballer?
For me, I just think you should know as a person that when you have a career, every guy is born with something in them. They know how to do best, and I realized that when I was very young. When I was playing with my bare foot, I know I love football, you know. And when growing up, I started playing with boys club. And when you play, when you're training, people love coming to watch you. And then that's where you start to realize, okay, not just you don't have just the feeling yourself. Other people are also talking about you, telling your parents, oh, he's a good football player, you know. So those things really motivate me, you know, to really push in and really, you know, go for it.
Okay. Growing up, where did you grow?
I grew up in Ojo Alaba. I'm from Ojo, yeah.
Okay. So at what age did you move over to Denmark?
When I was 18, I moved to Denmark, yeah.
Okay. So your parents are fully in support of?
Yeah, they are.
Okay. What about your siblings? Do you have siblings?
I have siblings.
Are they also into this?
No, they know how to play football, you know, but, you know, sometimes siblings, they want to tell me, football, I can make it, I can do it, but, you know, it's not always easy. It's easy to talk, but it's difficult when you get to the pitch, when you don't want to work hard, and I don't think you can really go anywhere with football. So I have two brothers. They know how to play, but, of course, you know, not like me. So, yeah.
Final words to your fans.
Yeah, I just want to thank you guys for always being there and for supporting me and for always, you know, trying to, yeah, make the world know that, okay, I have to be invited to the national team. Just want to say a big thank you to you guys. I really appreciate, and thank you.